today's session, we'll be exploring in building a deep neural network to predict breast cancer in a patient or not. So here we have the just a description of the data set before we get into it. So we have parameters like the attribute one is ID number and diagnosis, where diagnosis is a target variable, which is either malignant or benign. And the other values for each cell nucleus is radius, texture, perimeter, area, smoothness, compactness, concavity, concave points, symmetry, and fractal dimension. So these are the features which we'll be working with. And this data set has no missing values. And another part is the entire one is recorded with 4 significant digits, which means it's pretty much encoded mostly. Before we get into it, let us import our necessary libraries for data wrangling, visualization, and pre-processing. We have NumPy, Pandas, Matplotlib, Seaborn. You are using sklearn's model selections, train test split in this case, label encoder for encoding and pre-processing, and standard scaler to scale the values between -1 and +1. And we'll be using an sklearn pipeline to standardize the procedure, which we'll be exploring now. Filter out the warnings. Yeah. While this is happening, so this one, as the name says, flow goes in a sequence to sequence manner, a layer by layer manner. And then a dense layer. Dense layer is nothing but a fully connected or a linear layer in Keras, which we had seen yesterday. And we have a Keras classifier, which is in under the Keras Kykit-learn wrappers, which we'll be exploring now. And from sklearn's model selection, we'll be using stratified k-fold cross-validation, which we had seen in our ensembling methods notebook, and cross-validation score. Here we're going to do a pd.read.csv for reading the CSV file, and then look at the first 5 elements using data.head. So it has an ID, a diagnosis, whether it is malignant or benign, radius, texture, perimeter, area, smoothness, compactness, concavity, concave points, texture, perimeter, area, and all. Let's look at the information in the data. So we have 569 entries where all the columns are non-null. If you look at this, 569 non-null int, and so on till unnamed 32. Unnamed 32 is a column which is not required, so that it just simply drop that values because it holds only null values. If you look at this, it has 0 non-null values. Just remove this column there by data frame name dot drop column name axis is equal to 1 to indicate that you are dropping a column. And then let us just check if it has been dropped. So in this one, the unnamed 32 doesn't exist. It was in the end after fractal dimension worst. So it has been dropped. And now we have already done the feature selection in this. So we wouldn't have to get into that entire exercise of feature selection, which we had learned previously in our machine learning sessions. So here we have the columns that are going to help us predict whether a patient has breast cancer or not. So these are the columns. Let us just separate the independent and the dependent variables. The dependent variable is diagnosis. Just define them as of now. And then encode the dependent variable. You have to convert the... What label encoding does is the categorical data will be converted to numeric data if it is a non-numerical value. So we have defined a label encoder, fit it upon Y, your target variable, and transform it. Just do that entire operation now and stuff. So now we have prepared a data for training. Let us now define our neural network. So first things first, let us define a sequential model first. Sequential model is nothing but a layer by layer neural network where it goes forward only. Next one, let us add a fully connected layer with 10 nodes, and activation is ReLU function. So if you can recollect ReLU activation function, It has something like x is equal to 0 if x is lesser than or equal to 0, or x is equal to x if x is greater than 0, right? So that is the activation function we are applying here. And the final one is output is either A or B, which is malignant or benign, and activation is sigmoid activation function, which is once we explore the logistic regression notebook, that time you can understand how a sigmoid activation function works. It's actually interrelated. It works in the same way as logistic regression. And after you define the model, what do? You compile the model with a binary cross entropy loss function, atom optimizer, and metric as accuracy. That means the iterations, the model training and progress happens basis the accuracy of the model. So let us now define this model and have a look at the model. Create model. This is how you define the model. And yeah, and this is how the model looks like. The first one has 10 nodes, first layer, and the next one has one node, signifying whether it is malignant or benign. In this case, we're using a sigmoid activation function in the final node. So it's a very tiny neural network. Let us see how it performs upon this data set. So now we are moving into machine learning pipeline. So what a machine learning pipeline is and does is, it is used to automate machine learning workflows. Like from the entire part of taking the raw data to processing it, to feature extraction and all other functions, to training the model, you can pass it under a pipeline and get it done. So it's like they enable a sequence of data which is to be transformed and correlated in a model so that it can be tested and evaluated to achieve an outcome, whether the outcome is positive or negative. So here, let us define a list called estimators and apply standard scaler first. It is a function which is going to be applied upon the data, which is entering the pipeline, first level. Once you apply the standard scaler, let us add a Keras classifier, a classification model, whose build function, the model which it is having is this one. Create baseline, which is a function. If you look at this, right? This is the model you're passing into the pipeline with the 100 epochs. 100 epochs is nothing but 100 times the model is going to execute. And batch size 5. Batch size 5 means that whatever data you have got now, for example, let's take at x.shape. You have 569, right? So each and every training instance, it takes 5 data points out of this and 5 data points out of this as the independent variables and target, and then keeps training over and over again till it gets a good combination of weights and a good accuracy metric. Since we have defined the in the model.compile metric as accuracy, so that is what you do with the model here and add it to the estimators. Next thing is you pass this estimators as an argument to the pipeline creation function, which is known as pipeline. So once it is done, you get the results. This is the k-fold cross validation, the number of proper splits you get in this cross validation value. Then you pass the pipeline to the cross validation score results. The pipeline takes the data, apply standard scaler upon this, trains it upon Keras classifier and gets the model results out, and then pass the x. X is nothing but the independent variables encoded. Y is the encoded values for y, and number of CV value is k-fold, which you obtained from this, and then display the results. Since you get multiple results in this case, you'll be printing the mean of the results into 100. Since it comes in percentage values and the standard deviation of the results. Let's have the training go. So one thing about deep learning is that training time is significantly higher than that you have in machine learning. machine learning algorithms are, in one way, it's slightly smaller and occupy less memory. But on the other hand, in deep learning algorithms, the data has to be parsed and transformed multiple times. The weights in the neural network will be adjusted and readjusted over and over again till you get the proper model out. Okay, we got the results out. So we have a 97.18% accuracy and a standard deviation of 1.78% from the actual result. So what this says is, with a deep learning model, you're able to achieve over 95% accuracy in prediction whether in predicting whether a patient has cancer or not. So that is what this does with the help of Keras. Okay, so this closes the breast cancer prediction using deep learning.